Hello to all you beautiful people out there, and thank you so much for tuning in to HBC's Got Talent From Wherever You Are, a celebration of some of the incredible talent that Heronbridge College has to offer. My name is Zena Rose, and I am proud to say that I am a Heronbridge alumni and your presenter for today. It is so exciting to see a school that even during lockdown are still finding incredible initiatives to support the passion of their creative learners. And in that same breath, I would like to say thank you to the incredible Heronbridge team and introduce them, because they've been working tirelessly behind the scenes to make this show a reality. What was the process? A call out for all students with creative talents was sent to Heronbridge students, and we received a huge amount of entries and some incredible videos. Our producers had a tough time selecting the final eight, but managed to shortlist eight finalists that you'll be seeing today. As well as those eight finalists, we had four standby contestants. Now, these contestants were on standby for if any of the eight finalists needed to withdraw. Another huge shout out goes to those standby contestants for patiently waiting to see if a slot opened up. Unfortunately, it didn't, but our standbyers have a chance to win some of the spot prizes for the initial video entries. Our eight finalists have been working with our incredible coaches, Mr. Brian Schimmel, Dylan Petrovsky, Kaylin Damon, and Matthew Marinas, on their final pieces and concepts for the videos. This morning, you are going to see the finished product, and our judges, Carmen Pretorius, Graham Watkins, and Nicole Sherton, are tuning in to watch and assess our contestants. Take a look at our incredible judges.
I'm Carmen Pretorius, and I'm one of your judges for Heronbridge's Got Talent. I'm so stoked to be a part of this, and I'm sure that you all have the most amazing pieces. Just remember, this is all about growth, fun, passion, and creating something new. So if you don't win, carry on, be brilliant, because your gift is still valuable and needs to go out to the world. So I'm super excited to be part of it, and I'll see you guys there. Cheers.
Hi guys, how are you? My name is Nicole Sheraton, and I'm excited to be a judge on HBC's Got Talent, and I'm looking forward to seeing what you all have been up to. Much love.
Oh, hey guys. Sorry, just in the studio. Graham Watkins here. I can't wait to be a judge on HBC's Got Talent, because I know you're going to be awesome.
Our judges will be meeting on Zoom after today to make their final decision on the winners. So, what do our contestants win? Well, Stagerex Performing Arts School and Heronbridge College have collaborated to provide some incredible cash prizes and training vouchers. For first place, you will receive 1,500 Rand, second place, 1,000 Rand, and third place, 500 Rand. Gemma Marinas from Stagerex will be giving vouchers of the same amount towards either training, experiences, online courses, or showreels at Stagerex. To find out more information about Stagerex, please visit www.stagerex.co.za. In addition, five spot prizes of 250 Rand will also be given. We will also be seeing our four models' final pictures, where Suzette van der Merwe will be selecting one to win a professional photo shoot. All the winners will be announced in our announcement show tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. So you really do not want to miss that out. And now it's time to get going with the show so you can see our incredible talent. We start off with our vocal finalists, Agape and Rachel, who have been working with coach Brian Schimmel.
When I started coaching Agape, It became clear that she had no fundamental technique in singing. She had sung in school choir, but it had no formal training. And so I spent most of our sessions working on the fundamentals of breathing, of placement, and of resonance. She brought a choice of four numbers, and we finally settled on one that really spoke to her, and spoke to her to her passion and her belief in the power and independence of women. This seems to be a theme amongst the two ladies that I coached. What I love about Agape is her passion, her enthusiasm, and her desire to take all the information on board.
Hi, my name's Agape, and I will be singing at HBC's Got Talent. I think from a very young age, I was exposed to singing. I was exposed to musicians. I remember my dad used to put like a Michael Jackson CD in, and I would just sing there, and my parents would sit there, and my brothers would watch me, and I'd be like singing there for everyone. So I think for me, that was the first time I really like fell in love with singing. And for me, ever since then, I've just been so in love doing like productions at school, and also at church. It's just been so awesome. Yeah. I don't want to become a singer or musician necessarily as my main job, but I'd love to do it as a side job, you know, singing at weddings, at functions, and also because I want to become a pediatrician, I'd love to use my singing to, you know, bring a smile to the kids' faces. For me, it's been absolutely fantastic working with Brian. He's so inspirational. He really put effort into me. He really helped me better myself, and he gave me such constructive criticism. Yeah, it's been an awesome learning experience for me. I don't think I've ever learned so much in such a short period of time. So I chose Alicia Keys. I've been a stan and a big fan since day one. I love her songs. I love her presence, the way she carries herself, her voice, her passion. She's beautiful. And for me, it was really about empowering women and letting women know that they have a voice and really fighting against all the injustices that we've seen with women in our country. My name is Agafili Dimu, and my competition piece is This Girl is on Fire by Alicia Keys.
She's just a girl, but she's on fire. Hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire. Filled with catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away. Seeing, oh, she's got both feet on the ground and she's burning it down. Oh, she's got her head in the clouds and she's not backing down. This girl is on fire. But she's a flame, so bright she can burn your eyes. Better look the other way. You can try, but you'll never forget her name. She's on top of the world, honest of the hardest girl. Singing, oh, we've got both feet on the ground and we're burning it down. Oh, everybody stares as she goes by, cause they can see the flame that's in her eyes. Watch her, she's lighting up the night, but nobody knows that she's a lonely girl, and it's a lonely world. But she gon' let it burn.
I am beautiful.
I am enough.
I am worthy.
I am powerful.
We are the future.
All of Rachel's years of studying at Stageworks and being involved in Stageworks productions, including Born to Perform, have informed what she has brought into this video. She has an air of experience and an air of maturity that is far beyond her years. She was clear in her choices about her song, about the intent, about the context, and the visual elements of her video. She has chosen a really, really vocally and textually challenging number. She has chosen the Catherine Parr number from Six, the musical about the six wives of Henry VIII. But she has made it a song about overcoming a bad relationship and the power and independence and defiance of women.
Hi, I'm Rachel Leah, and I will be performing a song at HBC's Got Talent. So I've always grown up in a musical family, and I was taken along in my little pram everywhere. I went to all of my sister and my brother's gigs and performances and concerts. And one day when I was 4 years old, I decided that I was also going to sing on stage with my sister. And my very first, I stayed fit, and that is where I developed my love for singing. I was 4 years old and she was 16, and it's been my passion ever since. Throughout this process, Brian has helped me take my voice to a new extreme. At the start, when I showed him my piece, he told me that I don't need to cut the song, and I was very confused, and I was like, no, but we have to cut the song because I can't do the end. And Brian said, nonsense, Rachel, of course you can. And he pushed me, and he took my voice to a new extreme, which it's never been to before. So the piece that I have chosen is from the musical Six. I was privileged enough to see Six live in London. So originally the song in context is about King Henry VIII and how he exploited his six wives. So I have taken the song out of context slightly. And you'll see when I perform it, through the use of the lyrics, I have decided to raise my voice for those who can't raise theirs. I am Rachel Leah, and this is my competition entry of I Don't Need Your Love.
You know I love you, boy, in every single way. Though I love you, boy, I'll miss you every day. Oh, I love you, boy, I wish that I could stay with you and keep the life I made with you. And even though I'm holding back the tears tonight. It's true, I'll never be over you, 'cause I have built my future in my mind with you. And now that hope is gone, there's nothing left for me to do. You know it isn't true, I must say to you that I don't need your love. No, 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 I don't need your love. No, no, it'll never be better than it was. No, no, I don't need your love. No, no, I've got no choice. King, I stay alive. I never had a choice. Been a wife twice before just to survive. I ain't got a choice. If Henry says it's you, then it's you. No matter what I feel, it's what I have to do. But if somehow I had that choice, no, never belong to you, 'cause I am joy to enjoy till there's something new. As if I'm gonna give up my work, my boy, my dreams to care for you. Darling, get a clue, there's nothing you can do. I don't need your love, no, no. I don't need your love, no, no. There's nothing left to discuss, no.
But I can't say that. Not to the king. So this is goodbye. Oh, my love, Rachel.
So I sent that letter to my love, got married to the king, became the one who survived. I've told you about my life, the final wife. But why should that story be the one I have to sing about just to win? I'm out. That's not my story. There's so much more. Remember that I was a writer. I wrote books and psalms and meditation. Fought for female education so all my women could independently study scripture. I even got a woman to pay my picture. Why can't I tell my story? In his story, I'm fixed as one of six, and without them, I disappear. We all disappear. I'm gonna raise my voice. They always said we need your love, but it's time for us to rise above. It's no more than down in history, but tonight I'm singing this for me.
Wow, wow, what a whole wow, not a fraction of a wow, not even half of a wow, wow, like how amazing were they? Show your support to Rachel and Agape in the chat below. Now, next up we have our dancers, Justine and Kian, with their coach, Delon Petrovsky.
Hi everyone, I'm Delon Petrovsky and I'm the dance coach for Kian and Justine. When I first saw their dance audition tape, I was absolutely blown away. Not only are they extremely talented, but they are so, so different in their own way. Working with Justine was super fun. She comes with this energy, she comes with this eagerness, and she just absorbs whatever you say. Added to this, she's got such good technique, she has good clean lines, and she's a very strong dancer. Then you get the other side. She has this feistiness about her, and that comes through in the dancing. With Kian, whoa. Another good dancer, and so different. I've never met a young male Irish dancer who executes quick movements and quick footwork as him in a very long time. I haven't seen that in a very long time.
Hey, my name is Justine Tomlinson. I'm a dancer in HBC's Got Talent. I started dancing when I was 2 years old, and I've been trained in classical ballet. But I've also loved watching ballets, musical theater performances, and anything on a stage. I love performing on the stage and feeling the adrenaline rush of being out in front of a crowd. I have been incredibly lucky to have the opportunity to perform at both the Civic Theatre, the State Theatre, and in 2017 with the Joburg Ballet in their production of Snow White. I've also loved having the opportunity to work with children in the Eastern Cape in the middle of nowhere and teach them ballet, which is something that they have never done before. Dancing on stage is one thing, but dancing and filming it is such another thing. I've learned so much about different techniques you can use and different ways that you can shoot things and mix things in order to create a wonderful piece. So for this competition, I've got a completely new choreographed piece. I really wanted to combine my classical ballet background with modern and dramatic dance. I also really wanted to have a piece that people could relate to. My piece is all about searching for inner power and strength, and having strength when everything is going wrong, but choosing to thrive and live our lives. My name is Justine Tomlinson, and my piece is In Search of Power.
Hi, I'm Kian Stakler, and I started dancing at the age of 6. My passion for dance continues to grow, just as it has for the past 13 years. Irish dance has given me the opportunity to be able to travel locally and internationally. I've competed in competitions in America, danced at the World Championships a number of times, and competed in major competitions in Ireland. I've also been given the opportunity to perform in local shows and performances. I have thoroughly enjoyed the process of Heron Bridges Got Talent, and I hope that you enjoy my performance as much as I enjoyed making it. I'm Kian Stakler, and this is Irish Dance.
Did I really just forget that melody?
When I popped off, then your girl gave me just a little bit of a job. Baby, so cold, he from the north, he from the Canada. Man, go so low, I got nothing else that I can withdraw. Ran up the door, I shot my wrist, it go like sha sha sha, sha sha sha. I got your bitch in me, la 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 la, la la la. I shot my wrist, it go like sha sha sha, sha sha sha.
the talent that we have here at Heronbridge, yeah. But before we move on to our songwriters, a special friend of HBC and Stageworks, Mr. Nathan Rowe, has written a song especially for us, so let's check it out. Over to you, Nathan.
When there's no business, no show business, but Heronbridge gives me a call, I'll hop online, this is my time to virtually give my all. Oh, is that my reflection? My bedroom needs some attention, or I'll use a green screen. A quick pet extraction, lights, camera, action, put on a virtual show. When there's no business, no show business, but Heronbridge gives me a call, I'll hop online, this is my time to virtually give my all.
Thanks, Nathan. You truly are a star. Moving on to our songwriters, Jess and Mvusi, with their coach, Kaylin Damon.
Hi, I am Kaylin, and I had the privilege of working with both Jess and Mvusi. They both have a very creative personality, and it was very exciting for me to dive into it and to really get to know who they are through this whole creative process. I look at Jess and how she brought her project together. Jess brought a project together based on a movie that she watched, a 1996 film that she watched, and a series that she watched as well. I expressed to her in one of our sessions that when I listen to the song, I can actually picture this playing like in a series, in a Netflix series. So if we look at Mvusi, I had an extremely awesome journey with him writing the song. You know, I think it was cool because he was really being true to himself. You know, his song speaks about how difficult it is for males to approach a female that we like, you know, and he sings about how he wish it was just easier for him to be able to express his feelings to this chick. For both contestants, I was really proud for the work that they put together. I was really happy for how they brought everything together at the end, and I wish them both luck.
Hi, my name is Jessica Celeste Robus, and I will be writing and performing an original song for HBC's Got Talent. I've been writing music and songs and poetry for almost as long as I can remember. I wrote my first song at the age of 9, although to call it a song would really to be quite generous. But I found my passion for writing music when I came to Stageworks mostly, and it was encouraged. And I'm just very happy to have found this way of expressing myself, because truly that's what writing is, in both music and lyrics. If I could do anything with my songwriting talent in the future, I would love to write songs for soundtracks of movies and things like that. I would really, it would just make, I don't know, my entire career if I could just have a song in some sort of soundtrack for something, either a musical or a TV show or something like that. So that's what I hope to accomplish in the future.
Every day. the sun starts shining when you're around. The world is full of silver linings, but I can't see the cloud because you're the rainbow coming after the storm. So let the waters pour down, we'll stay safe and warm. And is it rude to say I want you to stick around? Is it too soon to say that our forever could start right now? We'll take it one day at a time. I'll be yours and you'll be mine, come what may. I want you with me every day. Weekends, spending time with all our friends, road trips and vacations. You're my favorite destinations, phone calls and love letters. Say you'll call me back, I say you'll better, and everything I don't know how to say. 'Cause I'm saving you for a rainy day. And is it rude to say I want you to stick around? Is it too soon to say that our forever could start right now? We'll take it one day at a time. I'll be yours and you'll be mine, come what may, come what may, come what may. I want you with me every day.
Hi, I'm Vusi, and I shall be singing my own written song for you. My family is very heavily influenced by music. My mom sings, my dad tries to hide it, I think, but he sings too. I've always loved music. I've always grown up with music playing around the house, people singing left and right. But with regards to me and my own passion for it, I fell in love. Well, I've always loved music, but I fell in love with it around age 15, and I don't know, since then I've just enjoyed singing and, well, writing poems, and, well, now I'm here because I sang a poem that I wrote. It's kind of weird, but yeah, that's how it came about. I do want to become a doctor, but with regards to my talent, I just want to have fun. If I can make, I don't know, someone smile, if I can just make someone in day better because I sang for them, then yeah, sure, I'll do it.
You're mine.
Sure, I'm really in my feels, hey? I'm not okay, but it's okay, I'll be fine, because we move. Our models were given the opportunity to learn a little bit about styling and taking their own photos from Justine Mack at Justine Mack Photography. They were also asked to come up with 3 lockdown looks and to take pictures. Chilled, shopping, and fun. This is what they came up with. Let's have a look.
I wanna say that I'm okay, but I still pray, baby, one day. You make up your mind and you tell me you made a big mistake. Through the struggles and the pain, I hope your smile never fades away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Baby girl, you're so fine. Baby girl, you drive me crazy. Baby girl, you're so fine. Baby girl, you drive me crazy.
I see the way she looks and ooh. I see the way she looks and ooh. She looks and ooh, I see the way she looks and ooh. Sometimes I feel like holding her hand. Sometimes I feel like holding her hand. Sometimes I feel like holding her hand.
Yes, girls, things we love to see. We look forward to hearing who will be winning the professional photo shoot at our announcement show tomorrow. And now, moving on to our variety acts, we have Josiah who will be rapping. Oh, I should never do that. And the youngest member of our competition, Liam, who will be playing the drums.
Working with Josiah was a roller coaster ride. He's the type of person who is very passionate about what he does. But at the same time, he is also very conscious of the appropriateness of the piece of work that he's creating. I remember having to tell him that, look, dude, this is a piece of you that you're giving out there. And I want you to be comfortable with expressing that side of you however you want to.
So, it all started in boarding school in Potchefstroom. I started singing for a choir called the Northwest Youth Choir. I sang for them for 2 years. I loved singing for them. It was an absolute journey with them. And then I left end of grade 9. Then I came to Cambridge, sang for vocal ensemble for a while. And then due to the lockdown, having some lessons as well online with vocal ensemble, I also discovered that I could like sing in the shower and rap while doing the dishes, doing chores, you know. It became more like a habit, you know. I really loved freestyling. I wanted to show that I'm multi-talented, that I can sing and rap. This is my interview take with Josiah. Thank you for your time. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.
So I know you like the guy, you want the money, I pay the money in advance. You know I got the chance, take 2 friends. You know that I got it, girl. We hitting the dance, you know that I hit it like flow. Yeah, we hit it like flapjacks. You know I wake up in the morning, I make you some coffee. You know that I got it, I make you some breakfast. You know I love you so. Yeah, check this out. Hey, you are my sweet Caroline. I don't know why you playing me, girl. I love you so. Why you be leaving me for the rich guy? You want the Gucci, the Louis, the Prada. I don't know why you want him. Yo, girl, I love you so. Yeah, I said, why you be leaving me? Why you going for the rich guy? But I don't know why you love this guy. But I don't know why you trying to leave me, girl. I love you so much. Why you be chipping, girl? Why you be chipping? You wanting the Gucci, you wanting the blesser. I don't know why you want the money, girl. I don't have the money to buy product, buy the Gucci. I don't have that, girl. But I love you so from the heart, though.
sometimes it's hard when people reject you, it's hard when people leave you, it's hard when people hold you, you know you got it. It's so hard when people leave you for another guy, you know that I gotta go. Hey, I love you so much, I treat you so special, I give you my heart, but you broke that girl. Why you leaving me for the rich guy? I don't know why you do that, girl. I love you so much, I made you some coffee, I made you some tea. You love the money, you wanted the Adidas, the Gucci, I don't know why you want that, girl. I love you so much, I gave you my heart, girl. Why you break my heart, girl, girl?
Hey everyone, I'm Matthew Marinus, and I had the privilege of being in studio filming Liam doing his drumming piece. And although Liam might be the youngest contestant in this competition, he is 100% pure dynamite. Whenever you see someone in the zone, in the element, doing something that they love, you can't help be uplifted yourself. And although he worked with Kaelin on his practice sessions leading up to recording his piece, I was there in studio filming it, and the energy was just electric. So well done, Liam. I love seeing you do what you do. And without any further ado, I'm gonna let Liam's talent do all the talking.
My name is Liam Benefeld, and this is my competition entry of Boom Dynamite. I was part of the team to try and break the African record for the most drummers to play in the same song. And this year, I am, I think, the youngest kid in this HBC Got Talent in grade 7 that is performing. Keelan, this one is for you. Thank you so much. Keelan has been the best coach. He knew everything, what I wanted and what I needed. So this drum piece has a little bit of solo, a little bit of the piece of the song, and I just want to show you how much fun I am having behind my drum set. That anyone can perform anywhere, anytime, especially in lockdown.
Hey, I'm Liam. I am at Figure of Eight Studio and I am rocking it here.
Came to
I'm saying, hey, yo, gotta live.
that I would say, ladies and gentlemen, is a wrap. Shoot, I wouldn't want to be any one of those judges, because to have to make this final decision, I don't think I'd be okay with that. But tune in tomorrow to the final announcement show at 5:30, because we have a special performance from HBC Vocal Ensemble Group and the HBC alumni, with the Johannesburg Youth Orchestra and some hidden talents being showcased by some of our HBC teachers. So you really don't want to miss that. You really don't. So I'll see you there.